Alex here from howtoelectronics.com, and in this video we'll learn all about BME280 barometric pressure sensor, which is a small metallic chip manufactured by Bosch. So first we'll interface it with Arduino and 20x4 LCD display, and we'll display the parameters like temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude, as you can see here. In the second interface, we'll interface it with ESP32. So after interfacing, we'll display the same parameter, that is temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude, on a web page, and then we'll interface the BME280 with NodeMCU, and we'll again display the parameters like temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude on a web page. So let's get started. So this is a simple BME280 barometric pressure sensor that is manufactured by Bosch. Actually, there are two type of BME80. That is, the first one is having 6 pins, which has CSB and SDO pin as an extra pin. And the second one is only having 4 pin, that is VIN, ground, SCL and SDA. So we learned about both the sensor I2C interface. That is using only 4 pins, that is VCC, ground, SCL and SDA. You can simply interface it with microcontroller. At the center of the chip, you can see there is a small metallic chip. So the metallic chip has the ability to measure temperature, pressure and humidity. Remember, BMP180 or BMP280 can't measure humidity, but BME280 can measure humidity as well. So the temperature range which it can measure is -40°C to 85°C. Humidity is from 0 to 100. Pressure is from 300 to 1100 spa, and altitude it can measure up to 30,000 feet. So now let's learn about the I2C address of this sensor. The default I2C address of this sensor is 0x76. In this chip, if you remove the solder between SD0 to ground, then the I2C address gets changed to 0x77. But in another sensor, you can see there are 3 metallic marks. The first two are soldered, and that by default the I2C address is 0x76. Now if you remove the solder marks and solder the second and third metallic part, then the I2C address becomes 0x76. Now let's interface BME280 with Arduino and make a simple weather station. So we have connected 20x4 LCD with 12, 11, 5, 4, 3, 2 pins of Arduino. A 10 kilo ohm potentiometer is attached to adjust the brightness and contrast. Similarly, BME280 is connected to I2C pin, that is, so you can see here we have done exactly the same thing. We have connected Arduino, BME280 and 24x4 LCD and potentiometer as per circuit diagram. Now let's go to the programming section. So first you need to include 2 libraries. So for that, go to the manage library and first type BME280. So you can see there is a library which is already installed. Now you need to install another library, that is Adafruit Unified Sensor. So just type Adafruit Unified and slide to the bottom. So you can see there is another library that is already installed. Now let's see the code. Y.h is for I2C and Adafruit sensor, and BME280 Adafruit, both are for BME280 library, and we have liquid crystal library interfacing the LCD pins. So by default the pressure at the C level is 1013.25, and this by degree command is used to display the degree symbol that is used during the temperature. So this is a header. So we have begin with 9600, and then by default the I2C address is 0x76, so we have defined 0x76 as an I2C address. If the I2C address is something different, it can't read data. Now simply using BME.readTemperature, readHumidity and readPressure function, we can display temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude. And then we can use the same serial print command to change into LCD print command. So the code is uploaded. Now you can see the temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude is simply displayed. So currently I am in the room and it is showing my room temperature, that is around 29 to 30 degrees Celsius. And pressure is almost 947 and altitude is 565 meter above the sea level. So when you put your hand on Bosch chip, then temperature and humidity start varying. As you can see here, humidity is increasing and even temperature is increasing. Now if I remove my hand, the humidity and temperature start going down. Now you can try with the wet hand. So you can see there is quick rise in humidity as my hand is weak. Now what we'll do is we'll interface the same BME 280 with ESP32. So VIN is connected to 3VIN, ground is connected to ground, SCL is connected to 20 GPIO 22, and SDA is connected to GPIO 21. So you can see we have done the same interfacing, just using 4 wires we have connected ESP32 to BME 280. Now let's see the code. So it requires Wi-Fi.h library, web server library, there by default, and Wi.s for I2C. These two sensors we have already installed, and I already explained this is a default pressure at sea level. So there are 4 parameters, that is defined by 4 variables: temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude. So enter the Wi-Fi SSID and password here. So 80 is the port for incoming and outgoing signal. So see, we have initialized by serial begin 11500 and then the I2C address is 0x76. So it will connect to the Wi-Fi and start handling request, and then it will send the parameters like temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude. So when you receive the 200, it means the data is sent and it will request the HTML page. Now if there is 404, then it means the no data is found. Now this all line is the HTML web page. So if you have a good knowledge of HTML, you can understand what the HTML code explains. Now simply go to the tools and select the board. So now right now I am using ESP32 development module. Select the port and then simply upload the code. Now the code is uploaded. So now click on serial monitor and then here you will get IP address. Right now the IP address is 192.168.1.18. So you need to enter the same IP address on your mobile browser or on your computer browser. So right now I will enter an IP address on my mobile browser. So when you enter the IP address, you will see a beautifully displayed web page with temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude. So when you refresh the page, you can see changes. So this is a refresh type web page, that is you need to refresh the page every time if you want to see some data. So you can see there is change in humidity after refreshing. Now let's interface the same sensor with ESP8266. Connect B into 3B3, ground to ground, SCL to D1 and SDA to D2. Now we have done the same connection, as you can see here, supplied with 3B3 ground, and then just to go to the code. So ESP8266 web server h.h is the library required for it, wired for I2C, and these two libraries already installed as shown. This is the default pressure at sea level. Define 4 variable as a float function and then change SSID and password so that your node MCU can connect to the Wi-Fi. Default I2C address 0x76. So if it will try to connect to the Wi-Fi and it starts requesting for the server. Once it gets connected, it will send the data of temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude from sensor to the web server. So if it is giving 404, then there is nothing found. Now this is again the same HTML code that is used to display the web page beautifully. So what you do is you select NodeMCU ESP2LE board and then upload the code to the NodeMCU. Once it is uploaded, what you did is you copied the IP address. Here I will see the same IP address that I got from Serial Monitor. So when you click the IP address, you will again see the same web page. The web page is beautifully displaying temperature, humidity, pressure and altitude. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel. I need your support. Thank you for watching.